the Xbox E3 2018 briefing.
I think so.
Dude. Windows 10, right there.
Please welcome the head of Xbox, Phil Spencer.
We got an Earth running out.
No.
I'm good. Shit, that's wild.
What up, man?
Xbox controller set?
With Halo Infinite, we will join Master Chief on his greatest adventure yet to save humanity. We're now at a moment of exceptional creativity in gaming. We can't wait to show you what Creativity Unleashed looks like for you. So to all the gamers around the world, across time zones and languages, to every single person watching us on TV and on Mixer, and to our largest ever live audience, the thousands of you with us right here in the Microsoft Theater, welcome to E3 2018. I'd like to personally thank everyone who's joining us from FanFest.
This crowd is much more energetic than the EA crowd yesterday.
It's nice.
It's a 100%
of the proceeds from your FanFest tickets are going to Gamers Outreach. Thanks to you, kids and children's hospitals get to game with their friends in their favorite worlds. It's a great cause. That's what I appreciate most about gaming. Gaming brings us together. Gaming connects us. It inspires our truest cooperation. It creates some of our fondest memories of competition and our deepest conversations about the stories within games. Most of all, gaming fosters real community. It reaches across age, ability, race, gender, and geography. This is why I've always believed and will always believe that gaming is the great unifier. And what unifies us is our shared love of this art form. Legendary characters who captivate us, not just for 10 hours, but for 10, 20, 30 years. Bold stories that inspire the hero within us. iconic worlds that are so richly imagined. We feel excitement in the air and danger on the seas.
There are a lot of Xbox stations.
As gamers, we are at a momentous time where creative vision and cutting-edge technology together are delivering the art form we love. So, for months, our teams and I have traveled the world, meeting developers from Japan to Poland, from the UK to the Ukraine, from big studios to single developers, creators who seize the full power and potential of Xbox One to express their most daring vision for games. Today, we've curated a bold showcase of their best work and ours. 50 games.
Wow. Oh, wow.
18 titles exclusive. With exclusivity. And 15 world premieres.
Strap in, dude.
Some will be first-timers on this stage, and others will be first-timers on any stage. All are imagined by the industry's greatest talents. All demonstrate what true artisans can create: mind-blowing art, immersive sound effects, breathtaking worlds. So let's jump in.
Exclusive.
You think they got the same guy?
Oh, man.
Yes. I'm already crying.
God, it's beautiful.
Okay, so we're not getting a mic drop.
That's fine.
That's okay. We're gonna be okay.
World premiere.
Not your fate just yet.
What? What?
Some time has passed since I found you. Your master still lives. They'll soon make use of his bloodline. The limb you have lost will give way to something more useful. You'll learn to appreciate its worth.
Oh,
Yep.
Your death won't come easily.
That's what it was. Oh man, that looks pretty fucking cool, dude. I mean, it's funny because Neo came out like a year and a half ago, and Neo was like a samurai Dark Souls, and now it's like Dark Souls from Bumsoft.
Oh, Todd Howard here.
Oh boy, give us some info, Mr. Todd.
It's a Fallout screen up there.
It is.
How's everybody doing? It's great to see everybody again. You know, actually, the Bethesda event is a few hours right after this, across the street. And Phil said to me, I'm having a few friends over. Why don't you stop by? And look, I know Phil is really, really charming, but damn, he's got a lot of friends. And the good news is, you're our friends too. We've had an incredible 16-year history with Xbox, going all the way back to the original with Morrowind. Now backwards compatible. And that goes all the way to bringing mods to consoles with Fallout 4. And now we are bringing the Fallout universe to Xbox Game Pass with Fallout 4 launching today.
Okay.
Okay.
And hey, since we're here, we thought we'd give all of you an exclusive world premiere first look at Fallout 76.
Oh boy.
You're not saving this for your own?
That's what I said. Oh my God.
Yes, Fallout 76 is a prequel to all the other games. And it is our biggest one yet. It is four times the size of Fallout 4. Set in the hills of West Virginia, you are one of the first to emerge into an untamed and very different wasteland.
After our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault Tech, but it was built by you. So that if the bombs do come, our way of life will endure.
Almost heaven, West Virginia. Life is all there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like the breeze. Country roads take me home to the base. I belong, West Virginia.
For when the fighting has stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. In Vault 76, our future begins.
Interesting.
They didn't show a lot.
No. It's definitely looking like Fallout, though. Was that the White House that with the protector arm running premiere. Around outside? Because the White House was destroyed in Fallout. Well, it looked terrible Fallout. Anyway. I can hear you, but I'm afraid to be near you. And I don't know where to begin. And I don't know where to begin.
It's just me, Captain Spirit. This is Chris of the Flying Fortress. Have you spotted Snowmancer? Not yet. Keep me posted.
Chris, breakfast.
Okay, Dad. You're drinking beer?
I don't need a lecture from my son.
I always get picked last for the team at school, and they never throw the ball to me.
They can't tell stories like you can they?
No way. Start the launch.
Too late, emergency. Ah. You're too weak to fight me.
This time, you won't get away from me. I miss Mom's smile.
Me too. Nobody's friend. You're probably gonna change the world.
I hope so.
I know so.
Really, Captain Spirit is here!
Oh, the awesome adventures of Captain Spirit. Download for free from June 26th.
Exclusive.
All right.
The only game built like me. Big, beautiful, like a skyscraper, falling at your face. If you want to play on my level, follow my lead. Somebody give me my jam. It's all about getting the jump on the enemy. No building is too high. 60 stories up, incoming. Build up that raw power. Grab more. Grow more. Nama, nama, nama. Big. Bigger. Jackson! Then you need that fire power. Homing rocket gun. Bullseye. Vortex cannon. Via. Graviton tether. Have you two met? And the most powerful weapon of all, me. And then I roll out like a boss. I can push off fools, pull up the side of a building, or even bust out my very own tank. Oh, yeah. Boom, shakalaka! Man, these bad guys just won't quit. They got math, mad scientists, and mad a master plan. Here we go! And it's just keep on coming.
You know, I think that character looks like Terry Crews. Yeah.
Long Terry Crews.
For me, he sells that game.
Nice.
We will take back our world from the scourge
of
the machine.
I think they might have announced that. Playing in here. Yeah, I like it. Really does some innovative things for video games.
Soon.
skies rained missiles, and the ground burned to ash, and the seas boiled, and people turned into shadows. So let us not fear the heretics at our door. Even with their iron steeds standing before us, stinking of machine oil and shining its heretical light upon us.
Remember, most of the country has been destroyed or occupied. Even those who speak our language might be enemies, by conviction or out of fear.
We will not falter! Let us steel ourselves against them! For this is our hour of glory! Amen!
Let's move out, Artyom.
Blood, they will get it. We'll cross it no matter what those fanatics think.
It's a great song for this trailer.
Yeah.
I love Max Attack.
Like a more shooty fall.
February 22nd. Everything is coming out on the 22nd. So that's now this day's gone. And what else was it that just got announced?
Anthem.
Oh God, an anthem. Oof.
Metro had me at its gritty visuals, brutal landscapes, and its mystery of the ruins above ground. What I love about our art form is the vast range of creative expression, from grim post-apocalyptic battles to hand-painted spirit guardians. Whatever world these creators build, whatever story they tell, whatever sound effects they use, we will work with creators to guarantee that their games look and play best on Xbox One. Like this next game. Generations have loved role-playing games from Inventive Studios in Japan. Our next game is the latest in a legendary series.
Talk to me, Goose.
For the first time ever on Xbox, Kingdom Hearts.
Woo! Sorry.
Wow.
Sorry. I just wooed.
It's cold! Guess he's too used to the beach.
Hey, Islander, what can I say? Look, even the sea's turning to ice. Wow. A walking, talking snowman. You really are alive.
Hello. Olaf, are these your friends?
Hmm? Nope, never met him. Don't know anyone blue, green, or who's oddly spiky.
Whoa!
Yeah! Ha! Take this! amazing. You can control ice.
Control it? No, all I ever do is hurt people. This is my home now. I can't go back.
You're on DPS.
I don't want to hurt anyone.
Look out!
Things they don't really
show a lot.
Roxas does exist. His heart's inside my heart.
The other Twilight Town is just data.
So what will Elsa accept? Light or darkness? I know I want to know.
Well, good for you, but guess what? I won't let her fall to darkness.
Throw me a lightsaber.
This Keyblade.
Is that?
Mickey. You're too late.
Oh, shit. That game looks really good.
Dude, they're showing, they showed a lot.
The visual fidelity of that is amazing.
Yeah, it looks great.
I want to talk more about
exclusive.
This
exclusive.
Doorway. I actually like meeting new people. Besides, the conversation with my friend here has reached a bit of an impasse. I think he just needs a moment to cool off. Now, I sense that you brought me something to inspect. Show me. Waves of change roll throughout the seas, and a new land is revealed. The Forsaken Shores. A place of darkness, where fire and ash consume all. And from the depths, skeleton crews will rise to curse the seas. An ancient evil set loose upon the Sea of Thieves. You have delivered unto me a portent of doom most terrible.
Yeah. Oh!
You just wanted to know how much it was worth, didn't you? Fine, I'll give you 10 for it.
Cool.
You guys will have enemy pirate ships, which is the last word.
Battlefield 5 thing that we were promised.
Jeg har altid syntes, at landet deres var vakkert og forstyrrende. Da jeg kom hit som barn, fortalte det mig historier om skabninger og monstre. Vi ved, at nogen er derude. Og
så er det for Kratos, der show up.
Exclusive world premiere.
Hello, baby.
Look at this be?
Wait, does that mean...
100,000 racing. Sure.
Don't tease me.
Oh, did see the license plate? Set a rise.
From Playground Games, Ralph Fulton.
I do love me some Horizon, though.
I know, yeah, I know that.
Thank you so much. It is fantastic to be here. Today, I am excited to show you the world premiere of Forza Horizon 4, set in beautiful, historic Britain.
100 cars drop onto Britain.
Forza Horizon 4 features dynamic seasons in a shared open world, and seasons change everything. Let me introduce you to some of our team who will be helping demo the game today. Please welcome Bill, who is online with a few friends in the beautiful English countryside. He has chosen the incredible new McLaren Senna. And say hi to Solomon, who is hanging out with his buddies on the streets of Scotland's capital, Edinburgh. Solomon is driving the Hoonigan Ford Focus. And please welcome Andy, whose off-road buggy is perfect for taking jumps, scaling rocky terrain, and having fun on the coastline of Britain. But first, let's join Rebecca. She is enjoying the summer in her highly customized Nissan Silvia. The sun is out, the sky is blue, and it's the perfect day for a drive. Forza Horizon 4's Britain is a shared open world. When you play with the entire community. And that means the other drivers you'll meet in the game will be real people with all the variety, spontaneity, and fun that real people bring.
Yeah, but what about my driver time?
Let's join Bill. He's in the same shared world as Rebecca, driving at speeds made even more thrilling on Xbox One X by the brand new 60 FPS mode. Meanwhile, Andy is bouncing around the dunes nearby. As you can see, Horizon 4 is still full of action-packed fun. And now we're going to show you how seasons change everything. In Horizon 4, every season changes the world around you, with each bringing its own unique beauty and unique gameplay. One of the great things about this shared world is that it's easy to interact with the people you meet. Here, Solomon and Rebecca use the new quick chat feature on the D-pad to start a new friendship. It looks like Rebecca has found some like-minded friends.
there a button on the D-pad?
It's great to play solo, but it's better to play with others. Horizon 4 lets you seamlessly enter co-op from within the game world. Seasons, time of day, and weather conditions are dynamic, but they are synchronized for every player, so the entire community will experience them at the same time.
Come on, mixer.
Now, as much as we'd all love to sit and watch the sun go down together, let's see how this scene looks in winter.
Oh.
We got a new track!
The entire open world changes beyond recognition. In winter, the lake has frozen solid, and previously inaccessible areas can be reached. The trees have entirely lost their leaves, and snow and ice cover the terrain we reached. The trees have entirely lost their leaves, and snow and ice cover the terrain. The visuals and the driving experience couldn't be more different. And now a blimp has appeared over the ice to signal the start of a new world event. Forzathon Live invites the entire community to come together and cooperate to win big rewards. And while they head off to the event, I'd like to show you how the world of Forza Horizon 4 looks in spring. Once again, the world changes completely with the seasons, bringing new driving experiences, new gameplay, and new events across the whole world. Every season, there are new reasons to play Forza Horizon 4, and the huge, creative, fun-loving Horizon community will be there to enjoy them with you. Today, you've seen a completely new take on Horizon. In Forza Horizon 4, you will live in a vast, beautiful world in which dynamic seasons change everything. Forza Horizon 4 is coming to Xbox One and Windows 10 on October 2nd, and I am thrilled to announce that it will be included in Xbox Game Pass on the same day. Thank you so much.
It really seemed like a scripted demo. It didn't seem like the people were playing. I felt disconnected in that aspect.
We know that exclusive games from our Microsoft studios are what originally turned so many of us into Xbox fans. My team and I take our commitment to you seriously, to make Xbox One the best place for you to play and for you to have the best games on the world's most powerful console. This is why we're increasing our investment in our existing franchises that you already love. And this is why we are amplifying our investment in new worlds that will deepen your love for gaming on Xbox. We embarked on a quest to find creative teams that have the mastery of our art form. And we found innovative game designers, master storytellers, exceptional world builders. And now, I'm proud to introduce the creation of a brand new Microsoft Studio, The Initiative, led by Daryl Gallagher, a visionary storyteller who has worked across some of the most iconic franchises for over 20 years. This new Santa Monica studio is building a team of world-class talent to create groundbreaking new game experiences. And next, I'm excited to welcome Undead Labs to Microsoft Studios.
Those who they bought them.
Not entirely unexpected.
This studio caught our attention with their visionary approach to building a zombie survival franchise. They just released their second infestation into the world, and in the first 2 weeks, over 2 million of you have joined the fight to survive. Now, it's my distinct pleasure to announce that we have acquired Playground Games. This is one of the highest rated studios of this generation, celebrated for their incredible craftsmanship. Not only will Playground Games continue to work on Forza Horizon, they're bringing their open world expertise to an entirely new project. We can't wait to share more about that later.
Abel?
And for the fourth new studio, it's my personal honor to welcome Ninja Theory to Microsoft Studios.
Wow. Good for them.
I met Nina and Tamim when we collaborated on Kung Fu Chaos back on the original Xbox. And a minute into playing Hellblade, you know you're in the hands of master storytellers who are fearless about telling bold cinematic stories. This is a team gifted in creating new franchises. And yes, we've got a fifth studio to announce, Compulsion Games. 2 years ago, we premiered a game we couldn't get out of our heads. A game that captivated us with its strong, fresh, and intense storytelling. We Happy Few is nearing its full release to gamers everywhere. So please help me in welcoming all of our new studios by joining us at Microsoft Studios. These five new teams will have the resources, the platform, and creative independence to take bigger risks, create even bolder worlds for you.
Truth is the enemy of happiness. Isn't that the decision we all made?
Oh, but you know the truth, don't you? There's not a thing I can tell you that you don't already know, is there?
Have you had your joy, Ollie?
People in town are getting a tad bit skinny. I think they're starving to death. And they're painting the streets in rainbows. Have you not noticed?
Oh, Ollie.
Why are you all wearing those ridiculous new masks?
You should get one. They shape your face into a smile. And when you smile, you can't help being happy.
We have to tell people. They need to know the truth.
No! It's better not to know.
Wakey, wakey, everyone. And it's another fabulous day in Wellington Welsh. Do what you should be doing, and you never have to worry.
Sally?
Arthur, we're practically the only two people in this entire city not stoned out of our minds on joy.
It's not a lovely day for it. It's a f***ing terrible day for it.
If you force people to have the emotions you want, then you turn them into robots made out of meat.
Where is it? Where's the blackberry?
You've gone too far this time.
People won't face facts. Not until we take their joy. And when we do that, they'll murder each other in the street.
Relatively soon. That game looks wild.
I'm really confused about that game, but we'll talk about it later.
All right.
Exclusive.
Console launch exclusive. 100? Oh, it's PUBG. Literally. 100 PUBGs fall on an island. I got the names of the maps on the card. Level. I think I get Santa. Okay. Hell yes.
Glad you're excited.
World premiere.
Oh.
That dog has a pipe.
Jakey walk in the mission.
Shut up.
I'm pretty excited about that. As expected.
World premiere.
Washington, D.C., the most heavily protected city on Earth.
Within its limits, 177 foreign embassies, 550 elected officials, and 23,000 military personnel. In the event of an attack, critical personnel are evacuated, underground shelters open, while complex defense systems patrol the sky.
But nothing stopped the virus. 27 days after patient zero, Washington fell. It began with riots on K Street, then shootings in the National Mall. Troops withdrew to bunkers. Civilians were left in the streets.
America is on the brink of collapse, but some people have survived. Gardens grow on rooftops, their fences patrolled with rifles, in communities that live under constant siege. Survival has taken the form of urban warfare.
Centuries ago, on this very soil, brother fought brother, spilling blood to forge the United States. History is threatening to repeat itself.
Now, in the heat of summer, 6 months after the outbreak began, a remnant of a corrupt state lurks in the shadows, ready to engage in a new civil war.
Agents of the division are the only ones standing against it.
But how do you save a nation when its enemies come from within?
All right. Interesting. You know, people, apparently the Division One really shaped up and people really liked it, so.
Presumably, we'll see gameplay for that at Ubisoft's, right?
That crash site is just ahead.
Oh, great.
They're in the jungle.
Duke, Kit, did you guys hear that?
Yeah.
Closer this time.
I learned a lesson about, like, scripted chatter.
The jungles of Washington,
D.C. Oh, my God. Where's the iPad game?
This parachute dropped right through the ceiling. Let me see if I can get this. Oh, that'll come in handy. So you guys are coming or what? Yeah. Oh, Merry Christmas. Here's the door.
Lipinski to the division.
All right, let me just talk to this guy.
He's gonna die without his meds. Those True Sons assholes confiscated him, along with most of our drinking water. Up around Pink
okay.
Water Station.
Okay, meet us at the sinkhole?
I wouldn't ask
yep.
for help.
Okay, sure.
I don't know what else to do.
Okay, definitely from the capital. You should have a new side mission on the map.
Yeah, we're not that far.
Okay, do it after the crash site? Sounds good. They're just ahead of us, Matt. Hey, I see you. I'll be up in a sec. Kit, we gotta get you leveled up.
I know, please help. I've been busy.
Toxic chemical residue
detected. One level behind this.
A lot of blue down there.
Hey, you guys should really check this out.
Almost there. So that's the control point.
Hey, wait for me.
Crap, they have a tank. Yep, I see him.
Don't aggro him yet.
Let me adjust my build.
Got my crossbone chem launcher. Chem cloud out. Matt, can you flank them and get a clear shot?
I'll take that sniper on top. Wait for it. Got her. Matt, look out. All right, let me try to get that tank off you. More bad guys on the other side of the plane.
Grenade, grenade.
Duke, come on.
Yep, yep, yep.
I can shoot that thing.
Matt, I need your help. Over here.
Over there!
Seeker mine out.
That's cool.
Whoa! Oh, I'm stuck. Use a little help?
Let's shoot it, man.
Matt. Oh, there's a dude rushing through the plane. Guys.
Yeah, I'll see what I can do. Got him. I'm down.
Yeah, hang on, I'll get you. I'll cover you guys.
Come on, come on. Get that weak point.
Oh, crap. Matt, watch out. Setting my drone.
Thank you for the revive, Meg.
I've got this guy behind the tank.
Map of the hive, nice.
All right, just lay it on him.
Again?
Drone down.
Now there goes his armor.
Ah, you're on your own.
Keep going.
Good job. Level up,
level 30.
Cute, even
oh,
bigger
sweet.
Enemy.
Alright, flare is up. Control point is ours. Nice. You guys wanna check out the plane? Let's go.
Let's go.
Analyzing ballistic residue.
Looks no like a found. Rough landing.
It finally leveled up to level 30.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Kit.
Good job.
Jesus. Whoa.
That's nuts.
Let's check it out.
Great idea. Let's just die.
So, game plan. Take the capital back. I think we're ready. 3, 2, 1, go, 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 go!
Wasn't a very good countdown.
Very bad.
Looks exciting. Yeah.
March 15th, 2019.
Thank God it's not
Please
February 22nd.
The head of engineering, Xbox Game Pass, Ashley Spiker.
So Ashley's here.
My superpower is multiplying.
This is a special time for gamers. We've never had so many incredible games to play. storied franchises, uncharted worlds, new releases, and cult classics. Genres we love, and genres we'd love to explore. There's only one problem. Too often, we are forced to choose one amazing game over another. So we set out to solve that problem. And to answer the question, what if you didn't have to choose? What if you could play them all? The answer, Xbox Game Pass. A way to give gamers the ultimate freedom to play. And your response has blown us away. Not only are you playing more games, you are spending more time gaming. Freedom of choice is leading to more discovery, more play, and more fun. And we couldn't be more inspired to keep building and unlocking more for you. So for the last year, we've been working on how to give you faster access to all those games. We leveraged the machine learning expertise we have at Microsoft and invented a way to start your games twice as fast. And naturally, we're calling it Fast Start. Unlike the current ready-to-start system, which is manually configured, Fast Start uses machine learning techniques based on how gamers actually play games. And Fast Start is designed to get better as the algorithms and parameters are refined over time. I'm pleased to announce that Fast Start will launch for select titles in the June update coming later this month.
Okay.
Ultimately, it all comes down to the games. We'll continue to deliver iconic favorites like Halo the Master Chief Collection, coming later this year. We also plan to release all new exclusive games from Microsoft Studios, including Forza Horizon 4, Crackdown 3, and more, into the Xbox Game Pass catalog on the same day as their global release.
But we already knew that, right?
Yeah, so you said that during this presentation.
Every month, we'll also bring new games from leading creative studios into your Xbox Game Pass library. Games like Ashen, Warhammer Vermintide 2, After Party, and Phoenix Point, all available in Xbox Game Pass the same day as their global release.
Okay, that's cool. That's funny. Yeah.
So that's what's next. But let's talk about what's happening today. Tom Clancy's The Division.
That's fun, guys. Yeah, he's into it.
The Elder Scrolls Online Tamriel Unlimited. Oh. And Fallout 4. All enhanced for Xbox One X in gorgeous 4K. And all of them playable today in Xbox Game Pass. Thank you to all of the developers working with us to bring freedom of choice to gamers around the world with Xbox Game Pass. Thanks, everyone.
I felt like that was kind of a review.
Crazy.
this?
Yeah.
That game looks cool.
I thought I knew why I came here. I saw it, the end. It was so vivid. But now the truth feels further away than ever. I still have so many questions. Get hold of this.
Let's think this through.
Do you realize the tragedy you have unleashed?
The cleansing has begun. It falls to me now to stop it before it consumes us all.
What have I done? To believe.
You don't know that you caused all this, Laura!
You need to trust me.
We have to trust each other.
He wants to alter the course of humanity. If you had that power, what would you do?
September 14th.
That's good. I like all the recent Tomb Raider games.
That's a 2019.
Exclusive.
I did it? Okay. At least there's a skateboard in the game. I can't wait for the chat.
Exclusive.
Man.
They say you only live once. I beg to differ. I was born three times, and I've met death three times. My first home was Alta Nova. The curiosity I gained there cost me my first life. I awoke again in Tarif, the village of the sorcerers. I once thought that this would be my true home. Everything changed when I started to ask the forbidden questions. What exactly is the true nature of the Black Stone? What lies beneath the vast desert? Who was it that was calling me from the depths beyond the desert?
Awesome.
The world never paid heed to such questions. They just fought on, blinded, and hungered for more and more of the power. It is time that I, at long last, reveal the hidden secrets once and for all. Come to me if you dare to learn your true wretched self. Behold, I am Elezra. The darkness born from the desert.
Interesting. Wait, that's not Black Desert Online?
But it's
seems like it.
World premiere. True.
We've known each other a long time. You never had this much trouble.
Oh, yeah.
You gonna make it through this?
They're demons! I see them with my own eyes! Red Crane has completely taken over!
Let us pray for mercy. This is a trial from the heavens above.
Oh, nice. Wow.
Hey, honey. Need assistance?
Hey. Hell. You have to hit every single bump in the road? Where are my crew? Cheer up, crew cut. You taking that?
Yeah, don't make cry.
Yeah, he's real pro at smacking demons around. That's why I built him that well-functioning arm. To kick demon ass.
It's not like
a functioning arm. To kick.
What? No chit-chat or monologue? Just getting right to the point, huh?
My brilliant badass work is worth every dime, you know it. Cash first.
Tidier, get back inside now!
I've got a score to settle with that son of a bitch.
Devil May Cry. Nice. Excited, going back to the sequence. Oh, like, I really like the 1-4 a lot more than that. I missed the last few Devil May Cry games. It looks totally different than what I remember.
It does look different.
Please welcome, from Capcom, producer Matt Walker and director Hideaki Itsuno.
As director, I wait 4 years for this. Thank you so much. DMC is back. English is hard. Matt, you do it.
Of course. It's been 10 years since Devil May Cry 4 was released, and fans have been asking for a true sequel ever since. So this is our response, loud and clear, that we hear you. Devil May Cry and Hideaki Itsuno are back! Early on in the development of Devil May Cry 5, we set our sights on creating something that was going to have world-class visuals. So we've scanned fully costumed models for all of our main characters, and with the power of Xbox One X, we're able to render them as realistically as possible. Now, while visuals are really important, the controls need to remain tight and responsive as well. So we've gathered the best minds at Capcom to ensure that we can still deliver that amazing gameplay that Devil May Cry is known for. And we think that we've made something that feels better than any action game we've ever created.
Hold on, hold on. すべてのファンの皆様のために一番の自信作ができました、期待してもらって大丈夫ですよろしくお願いします
Itsuno-san says that he is convinced that this is the best game that he's ever made because we made it for you, our fans and we hope you look forward to seeing more
Have a great E3!
Exclusive.
Oh. Oh my God.
What is up? Hello.
Any DLC?
Well, well, well.
Love it.
DLC action.
I mean, next 20, year.
2020.
Okay.
Exclusive.
We had this on our show last year.
Mox Zelda?
See, the art style changed a little bit.
That's bugging me a little bit about this presentation so far. It's just, you know, we have a few even compact.
That looks super cute.
It does.
No release date?
Yeah, that sucks.
That tiny fox in a big world is a prime example of the reach of gaming today. A labor of love conceived and created by a single developer in Halifax, Nova Scotia, is today commanding gaming's largest stage. Whether you're sharing the adventure of a tiny fox with more than 20 million viewers on Mixer, or teaming up with Xbox Live friends to slay zombies, gaming is an incredible community. We've always believed that building community is vital for gaming. There's real power in our shared experience, sharing the same world, the same seasons, the same campaigns. And there's real meaning in sharing our love of gaming with fellow gamers. This community is the reason why we love premiering games here at E3. For the rest of our briefing, Everything you show you will be world premiere games no one has seen before.
Here we go. Come on, Fable.
Starting off with something entirely new from our friends at Bandai Namco. On my last trip to Japan, their creative team showed me a sneak peek at their next game. Now, you get to see the first look.
World premiere. There are worlds that exist, separate from our own, where the impossible is reality. They consist of both good and evil. These worlds were never meant to meet.
Announcer style.
But things have changed. Now, they have begun to merge as one. And our last hope are the heroes we could only imagine, uniting to fight heroes we could only imagine, uniting to fight for our survival.
That's a great name.
Oh, wow.
Unite to fight.
The anime fighting game. Great anime.
World premiere.
World premiere means also on PlayStation. That's code for?
It's been 15 years since the fall. The city is a corpse, and we are the worms. We burrow in it, fighting for every useful piece of land to preserve ourselves from the terrors of the night and the horrors of the day.
Know not who can hear my voice. I shall therefore speak a word unto here. Anyone who dares to steal food will be hanged, and their bodies will be exposed.
Every day we rise from dust to choose between bad and worse.
Oh, it's dying light, maybe?
You're dead now!
These choices we take to survive will create the world to come.
You know the drill. Get to the nearest safe house and wait until dawn. Good night. And good luck.
Looks pretty cool.
Please welcome narrative designer Chris Avalon.
I'm Chris Avalon, and I'm excited to be working with Techland to create the world of Dying Light 2. Dying Light 2 is everything you'd expect from a bold sequel to the first game. A fluid parkour system with improved natural movement, deep and tactical first-person melee combat, and of course, terrifying nights when the infected emerge from the depths of the city to feed on anyone they can find. At the same time, we invite you to a new vision of the post-apocalypse. A bleak and unforgiving reality that we call the modern Dark Ages. Today, however, we want to give you a look at one of the impressive new features of Dying Light 2, a technical and narrative advancement for the franchise. Dying Light 2 will be the first in its genre where your choices have genuine consequences in the game itself. From how it looks, how it plays, to the events that occur, everything in the game world can change based on your decisions. The following demo throws a bit more light on this.
You guys play the first one?
It had really good movement. Mm-hmm. That's the only thing I like about it.
I didn't like the weapon damage system of, you know, your weapons run out.
No.
And then I played Breath of the Wild. And like this better.
I'm pretty burnt on that zombie genre though.
Dying Light 2 features a functioning ecosystem that reacts on multiple levels to the things you do and the choices you make. In the example we are about to show you, our protagonist undertakes a mission for the Peacekeepers, one of the many factions active in the city. They want you to negotiate with two survivors who are controlling and hoarding a water supply.
You going to solve this with another
environment looks way cooler.
Yeah, that's good.
Let's say you choose to carry out the Peacekeepers' orders, one way or another.
One more color in this one.
After this, you will start seeing a significant change in the city as access to the water supply allowed the Peacekeepers to bring stability and develop the area. There's even running water for the people at street level, and that raises their morale and allows you to replenish your energy on the go. But there's a cost to this. The PKs have a rigid approach to law and order. So while the streets may be safer, it's only safer for those who side with them. So if you get on their bad side. Now let's return to that moment of choice. And instead of killing them, you choose to team up with this group to supply water on the black market. As you will see, this creates a very different set of consequences for the city. With water being a precious currency, it brings you access to new resources and trade. But this, in turn, attracts the worst type of people to the area. And this is just a single decision, one out of hundreds you will have to make. But it allows you to carve out your own world. Each player's game experience will be unique. And by the way, this is just what happens in the day. At night, well, things tend to get a lot darker.
It's like a cool concept with the unique world and the choices affecting stuff, if they can execute on it. Yeah. It's what I want in a sequel. I want them to do something
exclusive
new and different based on something
premiere
that was fresh. Right. And it looks good. I like the way that looks.
A lot of time has passed. You've gotten soft, complacent. You always knew this day would come. You always knew the three of you would be needed again. You always... Wait, what?
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 A brand new game featuring body-morphing genre mashups, three-player couch co-op, 4K hand-drawn 2.5D graphics, and broad, non-specific feature declarations. They're back.
Oh, man.
Man, there'd be a lot of people excited.
So the shirt was not just a troll.
You know, you can call GameStop in 2019 and ask if they have Battletoads.
World premiere.
Can't hang up on that.
I was born to fight wars that no army could win.
Almost cause four? Yep.
There was no fear. No failure. But the rules have changed. The enemy changed. And no one was ready for it.
Like any of a tornado with your gliding features.
They are the world's most powerful private army.
but even they should fear what they've created. This isn't a war, Rico. This is survival.
Does that happen a lot?
What, me getting shot at? All the time.
Yeah, I'm up board with that. What a great trailer for that game.
Yeah. Is Just Cause the most gif-able game?
It could be.
Yeah. World premiere.
First party stuff.
Oh.
Oh, here we go.
They didn't say exclusive, though, which I find interesting.
What? Get out of here.
Wait, what?
Oh my god.
Was it Gears Chibi?
Yes.
The Funko.
Gears Funko.
Oh, yeah, Funko, yeah.
Oh my god. The Gears fan base is gonna be so mad.
Wow.
That is it's a mobile game.
A mobile game.
Wow.
Oh, it's mobile? Well, that's the way you show a mobile game.
Yep.
On a
now, now follow it up with the real version.
Studio head, Rod Ferguson. Mm-hmm.
Let's get some shoutcasting esports Gears Pop going. And Xbox is with the Gears logo on.
We've had logos for
13 years ago, when I began my Gears of War journey, we had no idea how big this franchise would become. And as it's grown, we've dreamed of taking it to new places and different ways to reach even more fans. And that's why today we're announcing Gears Pop, a collaboration with our friends at Funko to bring a unique mobile spin to the world of Gears.
And
mobile
too, right?
is not the only new place we're going. Good. I'm excited to also announce a true Gears of War PC experience in a completely different genre, Gears Tactics.
What?
You create a whole new squad 12 years before Gears of War 1 as they hunt a locust monster maker responsible for destroying whole cities.
It's
our take on the
yeah.
classic turn-based strategy genre
oh,
with a
cool.
character-driven story,
cool.
faster, more aggressive
Perfect.
Gameplay, a customizable squad
of
equipment,
dude.
And of course, it wouldn't be a Gears game without a massive boss battle.
All right, so that's two new Gears games. The rumor was three new Gears games.
We look forward to sharing more about Tactics with you soon. But it's not just about going to new places. It's also about having new experiences. And the amazing team at the Coalition is working hard to bring you our most ambitious Gears of War title yet, Gears 5.
Whoa. Okay, so, all right, so that is, there's the third.
The rumor that was paired with that is more Fable as well.
They call burying the lead. It's top billing.
As Kate, you'll journey across the biggest and most beautiful world we've ever created, with the war for humanity escalates on two fronts, outside the capital city, and within Kate herself. In this moment from the game, Kate leads a rescue message to a remote village, but something goes horribly wrong.
Let's see it. I'm excited about Gears now.
Kate.
No.
Kate, you can't see this. You don't want to see this. Sorry.
Thanks for coming here.
Of course.
Can I recommend we maybe get these people out of here?
Hey, just slow down. No, Foz is right. We need to move.
What are you talking? He's dead, man. Give her a minute.
She'll get her minute in the Raven.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Del, we need to leave.
I'm not going.
Excuse me?
For months now, I've been having these dreams. Nightmares. But I think they were messages.
What?
Something's happening to me.
It's your grandmother's?
Enough. We'll deal with this later. Foz, round these people up.
I need help.
There's a place up north. I think we can find you answers there.
No, no.
Absolutely not.
We have orders.
You'll go with me.
God damn it, both of you, listen.
I'll go with her. Look, if you're missing, Jen will notice. Okay. I'll push Jack the coordinates.
No, Corporal, you're coming back to Nuafira. That is a direct order.
Well, Captain, screw your order. This isn't about you, it's about me. I need to fix this.
Hey, watch her. A necklace? That's a locust symbol.
Yeah, so?
She would never be our enemy by choice. I know that.
Because she would die for us.
I know that. But what if it's not her choice?
Over the top.
In the female lead, though. History of That's Xbox, interesting. In the entire history of E3, in the entire history of our industry, gaming is now at its most vibrant. Today, we shared our commitment to giving you the freedom to discover and play all of the great new games coming to Xbox Game Pass. Today, we showcased more games than we ever have before. 50 games, 18 titles with exclusivity, and 15 world premieres. Today, we shared our most diverse gaming portfolio in every measure, from breadth in art style, genre, and cultures, range in subject and setting, scale and story and scope and creative vision. And every one of these plays best on Xbox. The world of gaming is on an historic growth path, where the increasing number of gamers is met with the increasing creative power of game developers. In this significant moment, we are constantly challenging ourselves. Where can we take gaming next? Our answer? We commit and harness the full breadth of our resources at Microsoft to deliver on the future of play. Our experts in Microsoft Research are developing the future of gaming AI, so the worlds and characters we enjoy will be even more rich and more immersive. Our cloud engineers are building a game streaming network to unlock console-quality gaming on any device. Not only that, we are dedicated to perfecting your experience everywhere you want to play, on your Xbox, your PC, or your phone. And of course, our hardware team, the same team that delivered unprecedented performance with Xbox One X, is deep into architecting the next Xbox consoles, where we will once again deliver on our commitment to set the benchmark for console gaming. And let's talk about our games themselves. We are committed to building an industry-leading first-party studios organization. And as you saw earlier, we are making one of our greatest single-year investments in teams by adding 5 new creative studios. We have committed our team, our company, our technical resources, so we can declare to you today and next year and all of the years after that, you will always experience the best in gaming on Xbox. So choose the games you want to play. There are worlds to be saved, heroes to be made, and legends to become. Together. Thanks, and have a great Easter.
Oh, it ain't over.
What happened? That wasn't a blue screen, by the way. It was black. I know, right? LA Live is run by the MS-DOS server still. There you go, look at that.
Cyberpunk? Maybe? Axe. Nope, definitely not Cyberpunk. Project Red, the Cyberpunk dude.
Project Red, yeah.
In 1977, they voted my city the worst place to live in America. Main issues? Sky-high rate of violence, and more people living below the poverty line than anywhere else. Can't deny it, it's all true. But everybody still wants to live here. This city's always got a promise for you. Might be a lie, an illusion. It's there, just around the corner, and it keeps you going. It's a city of dreams, and I'm a big dreamer.
That's like information overload.
There's that was, to look that at. Was amazing.
Oh my God. What's that? Well,
I was hoping we'd see more Halo Infinite. information.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dude. You think you wanna play now? Hell of a press conference.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought it went really well for them.